Next, third term we are going to learn is the enthalpy of atomization. It is delta atom. You can write it delta H atom also. Delta H atom means atomization. Okay, just a representation. Definition, it is the enthalpy change. It is the enthalpy change definition. It is the enthalpy change when one mole of substance, when one mole of substance is converted into gaseous atom, into constituent gaseous atoms. Okay, generally these reactions are endothermic. Heat is absorbed. To break a bond, heat is absorbed. So example, like carbon solid, let's say there is a graphite, a block of the graphite, the atoms to separate. We are separating all these atoms, and what you get is a carbon gas, means all the atoms are separated from one another. Only atoms are separated. Here, this is also reaction getting this solid getting converted to gas. So we will call this to be enthalpy of the reaction. In this case, enthalpy of the reaction will be is equal to what? Enthalpy of atomization. Okay, more examples we'll take. And enthalpy of atomization of carbon, in bracket I will write solid. Okay, so next we can write Br2, this is liquid, bromine liquid. This is also getting converted to 2Br and gaseous atom. I am writing atoms over here. These are atoms. So here also enthalpy of the reaction will be is equal to enthalpy of atomization of Br2 liquid. Okay, more examples we can take. A methane, here I am getting one carbon atom and four hydrogen atoms in gaseous form. So here enthalpy of the reaction is enthalpy of atomization of methane. So this is gas. Methane is in the gaseous form. Lower alkanes are in the gaseous form. Yes. So this is the thing about the enthalpy of atomization. Next is the lattice enthalpy. Next is lattice enthalpy or lattice energy. Fourth is a lattice enthalpy or lattice energy. Delta H L dot E means lattice enthalpy. This is a representation LE. Okay, it is an enthalpy change. Definition, it is an enthalpy change when one mole of ionic compound is converted into its gaseous ions. I'll write the definition. It is the enthalpy change. It is an enthalpy change when one mole of ionic compounds is converted into the constituent gaseous ions. Means, let's take an example of a sodium chloride salt, which is solid. Okay, and this is what? Na plus ion and the gas. Gaseous means what? It represents an independent they are separated far apart from one another. Independent ions are made, and this is what Cl minus gas ion. Over here, enthalpy of the reaction, enthalpy of reaction, this is also reaction, breaking of this sodium chloride salt, will be enthalpy, let us enthalpy of a NaCl solid salt. In this case, it is this way. MgCl2, if it is MgCl2 solid, this will be what? Mg2 plus gaseous ion. Gaseous means we are separating them. Okay. Whatever intermolecular forces of attraction we are countering, that also. And it is written this way. So enthalpy of reaction is delta H, let us enthalpy of MgCl2 solid. Okay, so the thing, the lattice enthalpy will be always depend on, okay, I will write over here, lattice enthalpy or lattice energy is directly proportional to this way, Q1, Q2 upon R. What is this? Q1 and Q2 are the charges on the cations and the anion. More is the charge, more will be a lattice enthalpy. And distance of separation is more, less is the lattice enthalpy. Distance of separation represent, this R depends on what? Depend on bond length. Bond length. Okay. And this will depend upon the charge, as well as electronegativity difference also. More is the electron charge, or I will write a electronegativity difference. More is the electronegativity difference, more is the charge, right? Charge separation or magnitude of this charge. Electronegativity difference. Okay, so we'll take some example over here. So like if I give you lithium chloride, sodium chloride, potassium chloride, rubidium chloride, okay, rubidium chloride and cesium chloride, lattice enthalpy, highest lattice enthalpy will be, its charge is same, plus minus, plus one and minus one are the charges. Charges are same on all this thing, but bond length is small over here because lithium is a smaller atom. As we go down the group, the size increases, so bond length increases. So it is inverse related. More is the bond length, less is the lattice enthalpy. So this is the decreasing order of the lattice enthalpy. So I'll write decreasing order of lattice energy. Okay, so if I ask between a magnesium oxide and magnesium sulfide, which will be having highest? Oxygen, sulfur, selenium. Oxygen is a smaller atom than a sulfur. As we go down the group, size increases. So bond length will increase, no? Magnesium, sulfur. So this is the order. Okay. Okay, let's understand the application of this. How all the enthalpies and energies could be synced using a Hess law of the constant in summation. Hess law is so important, although it is a small statement, you know, whether the reaction takes place in a one step or a two step, enthalpy change is same, right? It is a small statement, but it has a big application. We'll consider this. Let's say a magnesium, this is application of the Hess law, is Born-Haber cycle. We'll draw this magnesium and Cl2. Chlorine will be existing as a gas. This is existing as a solid. So this is what? MgCl2. So over here, enthalpy of the reaction, since one mole of the chlorine is formed, magnesium is in the standard state, chlorine is also in the standard state. So enthalpy of the reaction will be what? Enthalpy of formation of MgCl2. So using whole of the Born-Haber cycle, we can find, you know, so first,
we can find the enthalpy of the reaction for this, or we can find the enthalpy of formation of the MgCl2. Okay, so what I do is magnesium, first I convert this to magnesium gas. Okay, what is this process? Solid changing to the gas. It is sublimation. This process is sublimation. So this will be enthalpy of sublimation. Okay, now this from here to here, this is also gaseous, this is also gaseous. This is a new term called as bond enthalpy, not atomization. Atomization is solid to some other gaseous atoms. Here it is converted from gaseous to gaseous constant ion. So this is bond dissociation enthalpy. So I'll write delta H. Further I'll discuss about this. As of now you just understand that there is bond dissociation enthalpy. Now what is this? If I want to convert this to Mg2 plus gas, it is also a gas. I have to remove two electrons from the magnesium, right? So what I'll write, delta H1 ionization enthalpy. Like when you remove an electron from one electron from the any atom, it is energy is required. That energy is called as ionization enthalpy 1. When you remove one more electron, you will require one more amount of the energy, that is ionization enthalpy 2. Then you will get this Mg2 plus. Then what is this? Converting this to Cl minus gas. Converting this to this. So this is what? 2 times delta H. Can someone guess what I'll write over here? Yes. It is, you are adding an electron to this. So it is electron gain enthalpy. Okay, yeah, electron gain enthalpy of Cl. Right? Now if you see from here, this and this, if you are writing an arrow in this direction, this is getting combined, right, to form a MgCl2. But if I am breaking it, this is a solid salt, right, this is a solid salt. If I am breaking its components into its ions, which are into the gaseous forms, this other way process is called as what? Lattice enthalpy. So I will write this is to be delta H lattice enthalpy. You can go back and check the definitions of the lattice enthalpy. So lattice enthalpy is this of MgCl2 solid, isn't it? So this is whole a flow diagram. Now how we can find, so this from here to here is the enthalpy of the reaction, delta RH. So I'll try to manage everything over here in this part, or I'll write this over here, delta H. This process is delta H lattice enthalpy of MgCl2 solid. Opposite, it is lattice enthalpy. Okay, so this arrow is opposite. So how you write the enthalpy of the reaction? So this enthalpy of the reaction is equal to, or which is equal to enthalpy of the formation, right? So enthalpy of the formation will write delta H F of MgCl2 will be equal to what? This is equal to this plus this plus this plus this plus this and minus this, because this arrow is opposite. If it was in the same side, you would have written sum of that, right? So here I will write this is delta H sublimation plus delta H ionization enthalpy 1 delta H ionization enthalpy 2. Hope it is coming into the frame. That is the one of the concern I have always. Then plus, I am continuing this, delta H bond enthalpy plus 2 times delta H electron gain enthalpy and minus 2 times delta H lattice enthalpy of MgCl2. So from this we can easily find the lattice enthalpy, because this is given. If we know all this data, we can find the lattice enthalpy, or lattice enthalpy is given, then we can find the enthalpy of formation of a MgCl2 for this. So this is a whole cycle.